Yes, sir, we promised you a great
gorgeous
George.
Here
Ready,
it comes.
Blassie, the maker of champions.
Andre, the giant.
WrestleMania.
Everyone has a price.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is electric.
Hey, you are fired. The champ is here.
SmackDown after this past Monday night.
Well, they finally show their true colors over there.
And the report is being accompanied to the ring by Tamina from San Francisco, California. At a combined weight of 475 pounds, Jimmy and Jay, the Usos.
I'll tell you, King, this is going to be interesting. The Usos looking for a victory. Tamina, of course, in their corner, but Santino and Tamina have had some sparks in recent weeks.
Yeah. It's that, what did I say earlier? It's a pretty weird relationship.
Yes, yeah, strange.
She's pretty and he's weird. I don't know. I mean, if I had somebody that looked like Tamina almost throwing herself at me, I wouldn't be as hesitant as Santino has been to accept that affection, would you?
In fact, I agree with you, King. And in fact, the night that Santino qualified for Team Raw, back with a victory over Zack Ryder, Tamina actually came down to the ring and was very excited for Santino.
I know. Whoa. Vladimir's starting things off with a bit of offense here against the Usos. I'm just wondering if maybe when it comes to the opposite sex, maybe Santino suffers from a little bit of lack of self-esteem. Maybe he just can't believe that somebody as good-looking as Tamina is interested in him.
King, come on. You've seen some of the girls, the divas that Santino has dated over the years.
Oh, here he goes, speaking of the devil.
And again, the conflicted Tamina, so to speak. Very interesting, King, to see how this 7-on-7 SmackDown versus Raw tag team match plays out at Bragging Rights on Sunday. Remember, it's elimination style now, as we learned this week, meaning that it could come down to a point where one team has all seven members remaining against just one person on the other team.
Well, I'm not going to go so far as to predict that Raw will be that successful, but whoa.
Oh, and look at this. Kozlov, the 300-pounder.
You don't want to get in a shoving match with Vladimir Kozlov.
Also on Sunday, Randy Orton versus Wade Barrett for the WWE Championship. And King, remember the wild card there, none other than John Cena, who will be in the corner of Wade Barrett. Nice move by Kozlov and a kick out.
And not only in the corner, but with specific instructions from Barrett to somehow. I mean, Cena's, let's face it, Barrett has instructed John Cena to help him win the WWE Championship.
Another cover and another kick out. Can you imagine what John Cena, what's been going through his mind over the past couple of weeks since he's been forced to be a part of Nexus.
Now here comes Santino back in this match. Look of determination on the face of Morella.
Oh, and a great double team by Santino and Kozlov, although I think it stunned Santino as well. Into the cover yet again, and a kick out.
Santino's head used as a human battering ram, and well, Tamina looks a little concerned.
And King, this also, speaking of concern, really concerned about the matchup for the World Heavyweight Championship. Kane versus The Undertaker in a buried alive match. Now, you've been out here privy to call all four of them in your career, King. There's only been four in history. I mean, think about what the opponents go through in that type of matchup, knowing what awaits them at the end of the match.
Oh, my, poor Santino. That didn't work well at all. Well, you're right. I mean, the buried alive match is just, you know, what you hear The Undertaker, we've heard him over the years, utter those spooky, scary words, rest in peace. And that, you know, that's what this buried alive match is all about. This could be the finality. This could be the ending of this conflict between these two brothers.
Could be the ending of one of the brothers.
Yeah.
Oh, and Kozlov with the strength and power as he completely knocks the Usos out of the ring.
What a headbutt. That headbutt caught, is that Jimmy Uso in midair?
Not sure. One used to wear shorts, the other wore longer tights, but now they both wear shorts.
These guys are truly identical twins.
Now that's an astute observation.
Well, I mean, you know, there's...
You're a Hall of Famer. Here we go, hook of the leg and a kick out.
Well, I've seen some twins. One's a boy, one's a girl.
Can you tell the difference between the Bellas?
Yes.
And how do you do that?
The same way you do with the Uso. There's a tattoo. Oh, man.
Oh, look at this. And now great tag team strategy here by the Usos.
Oh, look out.
Referee
right
busy
throat.
With Santino, and the Usos take advantage. Hook of the leg yet again, and a kick out. Remember, a little bit later on tonight here on Superstars, we're going to see the tag team champions in action. Drew McIntyre and dashing Cody Rhodes.
Oh, dashing Cody Rhodes. Tell me, you really think the guy's handsome, right?
I think don't take it from me. Take it from the Divas. On WWE.com in a poll, the Divas voted, Cody Rhodes, the best looking of all WWE superstars.
Oh, come on. Did you know that they rub branches on his face to make ugly sticks?
No, they don't rub branches. It's called they take aloe leaves and they put it all over his face. And they put that mask on. Oh, look at this, Kozlov. Again, with the referee taken out of the action by Santino, the Usos are in control. Can Kozlov and Santino get back in it when we return to Superstars?
Santino has made quite a reputation.
Well, the expression has changed.
Santino threatening the Cobra, and look at...
I'm gonna teach you a lesson so good, you're going to call me Professor!
We are back on WWE Superstars. The Usos dominating Kozlov and Santino throughout the commercial break.
Boy, that's something you don't see very often, but you're right about that. I mean, Vladimir Kozlov's been grounded here, and due to quick tags and a little bit of double teaming, the Usos are definitely on top. Oh, there's a go.
Well, both these teams looking to get into the tag team title hunt. And again, that cheap shot allows the Usos to keep Kozlov isolated from his partner. Perfect tag team wrestling.
Whoa.
I'll tell you what, Santino better chill out. He's costing Kozlov. He's cost him a number of times here in this matchup, King. And Santino can ill afford to do that Sunday in the 7-on-7 elimination matchup for bragging rights. Hook of the leg, shoulders down now, and Kozlov powers out at two.
I'm not going to say that Santino's the weak link, but I'm a little concerned about Santino in that match representing Raw.
Well, you know, King, we were talking about the Buried Alive match earlier between Undertaker and Kane. First time ever that a championship will be defended. And look at this, cover yet again. Shoulders down and a kick out. Defended in that type of matchup.
Well, without a doubt, one of these two brothers will be buried alive.
Can you think about it psychologically where you've been beaten down, you're incapacitated to the point that you can't climb out of that makeshift grave, and then you watch your opponent actually shovel dirt on top of you as he buries you alive, and you have no way of getting out of it.
I was almost scarred for life as a kid. I went to see a movie called Premature Burial, and that's what that was about. I mean, being buried alive, and I've never gotten over that. I don't think I could last being in a match like that.
Kozlov trying to make a tag. He's trying to stay in this matchup. Santino would like to get in as well, and again, went for a cheap shot. Did the Usos and Santino counter.
Look
at Kozlov,
this.
And he looks to make a tag here and get Santino into this thing, and
he does. All right, Santino, show him what you got. Let's see what you got. Let's see a little bit of what you're going to do Sunday.
Well, that slowed the rally. Oh, hey. Great hip toss by Santino.
Oh.
Santino is cruising. Hook of the leg again. Usos broke it up, but it hit his own partner. Uh-oh, look at this.
Scorpion time.
Cobra.
Oh.
Oh, Santino ducked. Going for the Cobra. And it strikes.
He got it.
Hook of the leg. The Cobra does it again.
The Cobra. Devastating than a scorpion.
Maybe we can call Tamina's movie Scorpion. Nonetheless, Kozlov and Santino victorious. King, you think Santino can pull off the Cobra Sunday in the 7-on-7 bragging rights match?
Well, that's what I'm hoping for. You know, he really showed me something. Let's watch again. You'll see. Somehow he's got eyes in the back of his head, moves out of the way. There's the miss by the Usos, and then the Cobra strikes.
Ah!
Oh, 1, 2. Yes, Santino, we need the Cobra Sunday.
And look at the look on the face of Tamina, who still seems smitten with Santino. Remember, Tamina would be a great name for them as a couple.
Well, still to come here tonight on Superstars, big main event, tag team action at its best. MVP and Chris Masters team up to go against the tag team champs in a non-title match. Drew McIntyre and dashing Cody Rhodes.
I can't wait to see dashing here tonight on Superstars.
I just thought I'd better come out here and remind everyone of exactly who I am. I serve my queen with dignity and loyalty.
Look at that smug look on Regal's face.
And now the viciousness of the Regal attack.
Your natural xenophobia and jealousy won't allow you to like me.
Just mad at the world.
Every knee to the temple with authority.
And you people wonder why Great Britain is more respected across the world.
You want some?
Come get some.
My name is
My
John
name
Cena.
Is John
and
Cena.
I am right here. I do not back down from any challenge. I fear nothing and regret less. Love or hate, you cannot debate that I am in the center of sports entertainment, and I am surrounded by all of you.
For over over 60 years, the select group of superstars have had the ability to fill arenas and glue viewers to their televisions with their incredible gifts of gab. The top 25 talkers in history have been ranked by WWE.com. Do you agree with the list? Tell us at Facebook.com/WWE. God, I want to see that list.
You think you're one of the top talkers of all time?
Maybe annoying.
Yeah.
He's about his second fall, making his way to the ring from Blackpool, England. Weighing 240 pounds, he is the 2008 King of the Ring, William Regal.
3 days away from bragging rights, and King, I'll tell you what, I really like the way the Raw team looks on paper as they head into the match against SmackDown.
Well, especially after what we've seen from Santino Marella, I'm excited now. I want to see that Cobra pop up during that match Sunday night.
As long as he doesn't bring the Scorpion, we'll be okay.
The Scorpion, it's a Scorpion.
William Regal set for action here tonight, a sort of a rematch against Darren Young. He defeated Young a couple of weeks back.
And his opponent from Miami, Florida, weighing 242 pounds, Darren Young.
But a very impressive victory last week for this young man, King, here on Superstars over Primo. Remember, Darren Young, the man who was excommunicated by the Nexus a few months ago.
Well, you know, I still have mixed feelings about Darren Young. I don't know what Darren Young is like when we're not looking. I see that he's done something different with his hair. I think it's definitely shorter. I think that's an improvement. I just look for this young man to hopefully show us that stint with Nexus was just a certainly a blemish, but I mean something that he can forget and get over.
We showed, Young showed some spark last week, King, in that victory. He's a 242-pounder from Miami, Florida.
Well, he's going to have to show some spark to be successful against William Regal.
Yes.
Saw that already.
Very physical Regal, but notice how Young bridged out of that attempted pin there by Regal.
Oh, this kid, Darren Young, has all the physical attributes and look at this. I mean, you know, he's got the wrestling skills, but they'll be tested against a guy like William Regal. Look at Regal, man. He can tie you up like a birthday package.
Yeah, Regal just so well versed. That pound and ground style in your face, so physical.
Did you say pound and ground?
Yeah. Oh, you didn't like that?
It's not ground and pound?
Oh, I like to see. The pound and ground is the way that I say it. Is that okay? At least they didn't call the Cobra a scorpion. You want to get technical?
Oh, I guess you're going to throw that in my face the rest of the...
Oh, this is going to go on for months.
Whoa! Now there is a nice move by Darren Young.
Nice slam as well. And Darren Young quickly into the cover and a kick out by Regal.
Ooh, wow! Man. That'll get your attention. You know, Regal already holding one victory over Darren Young. He may be coming into this match thinking that it's going to be more of the same, but Darren Young looks like maybe a different young man.
Talk about Regal being physical. That was very physical.
I'm telling you.
Look at this, Regal rolling through here, and look at how Young again stays off his shoulders. Grinding that headlock in against William Regal here on Superstars. Just 3 days away from bragging rights in Minneapolis, Minnesota, the Target Center.
Oh, face
Raw
first.
Looking to avenge its loss from last year to Team SmackDown. When, remember, Big Show, who's now the captain of Team SmackDown, turned his back. Benedict Arnold, Team Raw.
Ow. Point of Regal's knee right into the face and head of...
And a kick out. Young. Everything Regal does is so physical. Notice how he just grinds the forehead with the forearm when he goes into the cover.
This guy can hurt you just staring at you.
Come on. This is where Regal's at his best, wearing Darren Young down.
Yeah, this is not where Darren Young needs to be. This for Darren Young to be successful in a match with William Regal, he needs to be flying around. He needs to be some aerial moves in there. He doesn't need to get locked down by Regal and grounded and pounded, as you would like to say.
Oh, what an uppercut! And Young really.
Oh my gosh! Look at this. Okay.
I'll teach the youngster some respect, I guess. Making an example of Darren Young.
You see. Regal, sometimes your opponent will just pull you up by your hair. Regal just pulled Darren Young up by his ears.
Oh! You know, I was hanging out with Miz this week, and he,
what?
He's putting, I was hanging out with Miz, and he's putting together some very inspirational locker room speeches before getting ready for Bragging Rights on Sunday. He's going to Vince Lombardi the entire Raw team to come out here and do what they can do to win this matchup.
Where were you hanging out with Miz? He go to the Cleveland Browns game?
No.
I was a big Clevelander.
No, we went to Starbucks, hung out, had a little
Starbucks.
Yeah. Talked about it.
I call that place $4. That's how much a cup of coffee.
Oh! Young to the mid. Oh, and a big uppercut again by Darren Young. And
man.
Regal again, just every time Young tries to get back into it, William Regal right back on the attack. Nice back body drop.
Now show us some fire, Darren Young. Let's see what you got.
And Darren Young swatted away by the veteran Regal.
Perfect description, literally swatted right out of the air like a fly.
Now it went for a full Nelson.
Man, it is hard to get the upper hand on Regal.
Regal just went straight into his man with a knee to the temple.
Yeah, running knee.
Young could be out cold. And this one's over. William Regal literally runs over Darren Young. But I'll tell you, Regal wasn't expecting this.
Oh, and you look at the look on Regal's face. I think Darren Young may have impressed William Regal a little bit here tonight. Quite a match, even though unsuccessful for Darren Young. Well, still to come, our main event here tonight on Superstars. You're going to love it. MVP teams with Chris Masters to go against the tag team champions, Drew McIntyre and dashing Cody Rhodes. Still to come tonight.
Every day I train.
Injuries can happen at any time.
It popped right off the bone. I knew it was torn as soon as it happened.
I've torn the pectoral muscle completely off my shoulder.
I've had surgery 5 times in my left knee.
I can't compare this pain to any other pain.
I heard something snapped. I knew something was wrong.
Please, don't try this.
You think you know me.
Look in these eyes. I'm a predator. I'm an opportunist. Vindictive, manipulative. I tackle the seemingly impossible. My name is Edge. I call myself the best.
WWE, the virus known
as the Nexus. Welcome back to WWE Superstars alongside Matt Stryker. My name is Todd Grisham, and Matt, a lot of talk at Bragging Rights about Raw versus SmackDown, but a huge night for Nexus as well.
Well, of course, Wade Barrett will challenge for the WWE Championship against champion Randy Orton. The interesting aspect of this match is that John Cena is now a part of Nexus, albeit begrudgingly. How will that factor into the championship match at Bragging Rights?
Nexus have been wreaking havoc on Raw for months. Tonight, their first ever appearance here on WWE Superstars.
Cena almost has to do the bidding of that man in the middle, Wade Barrett. And if he doesn't, John Cena would be fired from the WWE. What would that be like?
This Sunday, when I defeat Randy Orton, I will become the 40th WWE champion in history. And when that happens, my name will be mentioned in the same breath as men such as Triple H, Shawn Michaels, Bret the Hitman Hart, And of course, the man who will be stood in my corner at Bragging Rights, John Cena. Now, if John Cena fails to adhere to my instructions of bragging rights, he will be fired. You see, the thing that separates me from all those great champions that I've mentioned, the thing that separates me from Randy Orton, is that I am simply better than every single one of them. The Nexus is the most dominant force in the WWE, and as leader of the Nexus, I will become the most dominant WWE champion in history. And if you don't believe me, just look at how dominant we can be.
The entire future of Monday Night Raw will be changed here tonight.
I beat you, John Cena joins the Nexus.
If I win, Nexus is done.
Cena, STF, got it, tap out Wade.
There, it's a long, long way from those ropes.
Oh, come on now.
Well, folks, unfortunately, stuff like this happened.
Oh, man, what the heck? No! Ref, no, not like this! Darn it! No way! No way!
John Cena is now part of Nexus.
May I have your attention, please? I've received an email from the general manager. John, and I quote, "You must take direction from Wade Barrett. If you don't, I will fire you." This is a 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal. The winner to face Orton at Bragging Rights for the WWE title.
I'm ordering you to help me win the battle royal, or you will be fired.
This is all I've ever done. This is all I got.
Cena saving Wade Barrett from definite elimination.
I cannot be in the WWE.
And John Cena eliminating Sheamus, and it is moment of truth time.
I bet you'd love to drop me right here, right now. I bet you'd love to do it for the WWE Universe, for the C Nation. But you're not gonna do a thing, are you, Cena? Cause you're scared. You're a coward.
You're a coward.
You've let everybody down, Cena.
Yellow,
what a total and utter disgrace! John, wait. Hold up. Your duty at Bragging Rights, being in my corner when I take on Randy Orton for the WWE title.
It is Randy Orton and John Cena against Mike McGillicuddy and Husky Harris, the man who cost John Cena the match versus Wade Barrett back at Hell in a Cell earlier this month, and the reason that John Cena had to join Nexus in the first place. And Harris, look at Cena.
Shake his hand. In fact, I am ordering you to step out of the ring or you will be fired. Now, John, you have got the best spot in the house to witness the demise of the Viper.
The pack of feral dogs.
And again, Cena looking on, just helpless. Can't do anything.
it will be the slick and venomous WWE Champion Randy Orton against the upstart renegade hell-bent on changing the WWE Wade Barrett. But the wild card will be the forced hand of John Cena. The WWE Championship hangs perilously in the balance this Sunday at Bragging Rights.
Scotsman himself from Ayr, Scotland, Drew McIntyre.
There he is, hand-picked by the chairman of the WWE, one half of the WWE Tag Team Champions, Drew McIntyre.
Following Tag Team Contest is scheduled for
one fall.
And he is weighing from Ayr, Scotland, weighing in at 256 pounds. He's one half of the WWE Tag Team Champions, Drew McIntyre.
Ever since coming to the WWE, Drew McIntyre has billed himself as the most aggressive superstar in all of sports entertainment. Are you buying it?
Absolutely. Drew McIntyre handpicked. And what does it say for business when the CEO of a major corporation chooses you to be the next top star?
And his partner from Marietta, Georgia, weighing in at 223 pounds, is one half of the WWE Tag Team Champions, Dashing Cody Rhodes.
I can assure you no hair will be out of place. The teeth are brushed. The deodorant is on. The legs are shaved. He's as polished as they come. Dashing Cody Rhodes.
No wax in the ears. No blackheads on the nose. Nothing. Conceited, pompous, and certainly well worth the wait. Cody Rhodes and Drew McIntyre in action when WWE Superstars rolls on. Next.
Well, my name's Drew McIntyre. There is nobody on the SmackDown roster that can match my unlimited potential and aggression.
Here comes a young man hand-picked by our chairman, Vincent Kennedy McMahon.
Hi, this is WWE Superstar Rey Mysterio with an important message for the entire WWE universe. WWE Superstars are professionally trained performers. The moves we do in the ring take years of practice to perfect and to do safely. I urge the entire WWE universe to never try to copy what we do in the ring, at home or at school. Stay safe. Don't try this.
Set to prove that no one else in the league is in their league, rather. But Chris Masters and MVP will certainly have something to say about it. You can't discount this powerhouse.
Chiseled, ripped, jacked, and powerful Chris Masters.
But is he strong?
Yes.
And his partner from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 259 pounds, Montel Vontavious Porter.
Some new music for MVP. I like it.
You want to get the party started? Call Mr. 305 MVP. Things popping, little things stopping. MVP and Chris Masters make quite a duo. It's power, it's speed against, of course, the dashing and the sinister stylings of Cody Rhodes and Drew McIntyre.
Great opportunity here for MVP and Chris Masters to knock off the WWE Tag Team Champions. In fact, this is only the second time MVP and Masters have tagged together. The other time, they beat the Dude Busters. And if that's not a resume win, I don't know what is. So here we go. the decisions being made, which two men will start in the ring. It looks like it's going to be Masters.
Okay.
And?
Well, this is what the tag team champions are so good at doing. It's playing those mind games, and it appears that it will be Cody Rhodes, voted most handsome, most dashing by the divas here in the WWE. Did you vote in that poll?
I'm not a diva. So here we go. We'll be the dashing one.
Can you say it again?
The dashing one. Okay. And not only does Cody Rhodes do anything possible to win matches, he also wants to avoid shots to the face. Keep an eye on his defensive tactics.
I mean, again, who wants to get hit in the face? I mean, think about it. If you've ever really been in an altercation, you know what that feels like.
Rhodes sacrificing the back to protect the face, and there goes the chest. Cody. All the body parts getting exploded here.
Cody's going to need to use his speed to counter Chris Masters' power.
And now a quick cover here by the Masterpiece. He nearly threw Rhodes completely out of the ring.
Wise strategy by Chris Masters, trying to keep Cody Rhodes in his corner, but that's the slick, sleek ways of the dashing one.
I don't know how slick that was.
He ran away from Chris Masters.
He ran away like a scalded dog to tag in Drew McIntyre.
Now we're going to get the urban thuggery of MVP versus the Scottish ways of Drew McIntyre. What that means exactly, I am not sure.
What a year it's been for Drew McIntyre, an Intercontinental Championship as well as a tag team title under his belt.
You see the difference right away. Drew McIntyre going to a classic joint manipulation hold, trying to counter the arm of MVP.
And make no doubt about it, MVP wants to turn this into a street brawl. Would love to exchange punches, going for a cover here. McIntyre, though, has a different strategy in mind, doesn't he?
Drew McIntyre will do anything to win. Again, and I harp on this, hand-picked by the chairman of a huge corporation, certainly has to do wonders for your confidence, but Drew McIntyre can back it up.
Nice takedown, drop toe hold there by MVP. Trying to build some momentum and a big knee to the back of the skull. Going for a cover, hook in the leg, MVP, no. And Matt, this Sunday night, bragging rights. We saw SmackDown on Raw this past Monday. And let's be honest, we ran Raw out of the building on Monday night. What a performance.
SmackDown are the reigning bragging rights champions, as you see Drew McIntyre going to the knees of Chris Masters. Very, very smart strategy.
That's got to do wonders for the SmackDown locker room's momentum, so to speak.
Well, SmackDown infiltrated Raw, and some say almost even dominated Raw. And I like the momentum that SmackDown is building to this Sunday.
And we know that tomorrow night, on Friday night, SmackDown, the main event, the World Heavyweight Champion Kane goes one-on-one against Raw's WWE Champion, Randy Orton.
Yeah, the WWE Champion will step foot on hallowed Friday night ground against the cold and demented World Heavyweight Champion Kane. Only on SmackDown.
And the Masterpiece taking down both Rhodes and McIntyre. You know, we saw Chris Masters at his best a few weeks ago, nearly upsetting the World Heavyweight Champion Kane.
I don't know if that's Chris Masters' best, nearly upsetting. I think Chris Masters at his best is victorious.
Well, it looks like Chris Masters is headed towards a victory over the tag team champions right now. Can MVP and the Masterpiece keep it up here on Superstars?
Darkness. Six. buried alive. WWE bragging rights.
We're back here on WWE Superstars. This is our main event, a tag team contest. The Masterpiece and MVP versus the tag team champions, Cody Rhodes and Drew McIntyre.
Well, before we went to commercial, watch what'll transpire right here. Just a brilliant display of power by Chris Masters. But speaking of brilliance, clever tag team grappling will come into play right here. A blind tag, which of course means Chris Masters doesn't see it, and then that tag.
Sweeping the leg of the Masterpiece, and ever since then, Rhodes and McIntyre have picked it out as a big target, and it is a big target. 6'4", 265 pounds, the Masterpiece.
Cody Rhodes sends the urgency there. Chris Masters desperately needs to make a tag. Cody very wise to pull Chris Masters away from his partner.
Ever since winning the tag team titles, watch out! No one has really stepped up and challenged Cody Rhodes and Drew McIntyre the way that we thought they might. Matt, what is it about this team that's made them so dominant the past few months?
You're talking about Cody Rhodes and Drew McIntyre? I think it's their narcissism and their ego. They can't afford to allow themselves the embarrassment of any type of setback, and that really serves for motivation. And let's not forget, of course, their impeccable talent, their credentials, their pedigree.
Great team chemistry as well. Rhodes backing up, didn't even stick out his arm. Drew knew to make the tag. And now McIntyre, who can be so dangerous, so reckless, just firing away now on the left leg of Chris Masters.
Well, if you've ever stepped off the curb the wrong way or ever even just banged your knee on the side of a table, you can only imagine the pain that Chris Masters is in right now.
I've done that many times.
I'm sure you have, you clumsy oaf. And also notice Chris Masters' knee pad is pulled all the way down. That's courtesy of Drew McIntyre exposing that patella, the kneecap.
Look how aggressive McIntyre is right now. Not wasting any time, continuing now to torch the knee.
Notice that Drew McIntyre is pushing on the toes of Chris Masters. That increases the pressure on the tendons as well as the ligaments in the knee and ankle.
A chance here tonight for Masters and MVP to prove their worth, to prove that they should be the number one contenders for the tag team titles. But right now it's not looking good. Look at
Whoa.
McIntyre trying to take a cheap shot. No! And that allows Masters to take advantage. Can he make the tag?
If Chris Masters can tag an MVP, the entire energy and momentum of this contest will change. Here comes Cody Rhodes. Here comes MVP!
And the street brawler throwing lefts and rights.
Whoa! Belly-to-back suplex here.
And a second one. Look at MVP. Balling right now.
MVP certainly on a roll.
And then now MVP getting a shot back on McIntyre, comes flying right at us. It's like 3D television.
Credit Cody Rhodes for staying on top of his game. Oh, after receiving three German suplexes on the back of his head. Suplex, if you will.
Oh, and MVP looked like he just dunked Rhodes. And how about the momentum that MVP has gotten here? One of the most devastating jump shots in the WWE. Oh, the thing of playmaker, but here comes McIntyre straight from behind.
And Master Lock submission hold. But Chris Masters and Drew McIntyre are not legal. And MVP are.
And now Rhodes locked in the Master Lock. Out goes Masters. And like you said, it's Rhodes and MVP are the two legal men. MVP disposes of McIntyre. And look at that. Right to the eyeballs.
Smart.
Cody Rhodes. Oh. And Crossroads, the devastating Crossroads. See Rhodes digging his fingers into the eyeballs.
Here are your winners, the WWE Tag Team Champions, Drew McIntyre and dashing Cody Rhodes.
Can you imagine if MVP did that to Cody Rhodes' face? He'd be filing lawsuits, he'd be suing.
Well, Cody Rhodes has the baby blues, the blue eyes, and that's what makes a star, is your look and your talent. Congratulations, Cody Rhodes and Drew McIntyre, victorious here on WWE Superstars. Todd, take it away.
Well, it was Chris Masters with a master lock on Drew McIntyre, and then he puts it on Cody Rhodes. But as you can see, McIntyre stomps Rhodes away, and Rhodes, being the legal man now, had to deal with MVP.
Well, you'll take a win any way you can get it. Cody Rhodes with some ocular manifestation, and then the crossroads. Oh. MVP's head bouncing off the canvas. 1, 2, 3. Once again, Cody Rhodes and Drew McIntyre victorious.
So Rhodes turns MVP's brown eyes red. Ooh, and wow. Look at Chris Masters. Talk about a brutal physical confrontation. You just witnessed it here on WWE Superstars. We'll see you tomorrow night. It's Kane versus Randy Orton on Friday Night SmackDown.